हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस सेकंड सेशन ऑफ द कोर्स सेंसर्स एंड ट्रांजिस्टर इन विच फर्स्ट यूनिट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डेफिनेशंस एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट सेंसर्स एंड ट्रांजिस्टर and in that we have seen that sensors and transducers have varieties of applications in the different common general applications, and it can be used and it can be replaced for some manual objects. And then we have shown the functions of sensors and transducer. We have also seen about the applications of sensors and transducers. We have seen about the sensor characteristics, which are defined as the some statics and dynamic characteristics due through which we can develop its usage in different many engineerings and different electrical applications. Lecture objective of the today's lecture will be the classification of transducer. We will see the different classification of transducer based on the different its applications, and then we will see about the factors while selecting transducer for different applications. We will also see about the requirement of a good transducer. So it starts with the introduction about the transducer. We all know that the transducer is a device which converts some physical quantity into the proportional electrical signals, and that is called the transducer. Transducers is also a device which converts the one form of energy into some another form, that is, so that it is called a transducer. Here the process of conversion is known as transduction, and the conversion is done by some sensing and transducing elements. Here are some physical quantity which like temperature, pressure, sound and other physical quantity which can be transformed into some electrical signals. The electrical signal which are converted are produce maybe a voltage, current or some frequencies. A transducer uses many effects to produce such conversion, and the process of transforming signal from one form to another form is called the transduction, which we have already discussed and we have seen about that. A transducer is also called a pickup, and the transducer elements which transform the output of the sensor to an electrical output, which already been discussed. So the transducer will have some basically two main component. There is one sensing elements and another is one our transduction element. The sensing element is basically have a physical quantity or its rate of change is sensed and responded by this part of the transducer. That is called the sensing element. In the transduction element, the output of the sensing element is passed on to the transduction element. This element is responsible for conversion the non-electrical signal into the proportional electrical signal. The electrical signal that may be the voltage, current, frequency or any some electrical quantity. So let's move to the next slide, that is classification of transducer. Here the classification of transducer can be done in many ways or in different varieties ways. Some of the criteria for the classification are based on the areas of applications, mode or method of energy conversion, the nature of output signal, and according to some electrical principle involved, we can also classify transducer on the basis of electrical parameter which is used. We can also discuss it or classified transducer on the basis of principle of operations. We can also discuss on the basis of typical applications for the transducer. And broadly, transducers can be classified on the basis of transduction form used, as primary and secondary transducer, as active and passive transducer, as transducer and inverse transducer. Broadly, one such generalization is concerned with energy consideration, wherein they are classified as active and passive transducer. So component whose output energy is supplied entirely by its input signal, that is physical quantity which can be measured, is commonly called a passive transducer, or in other word, the passive transducer derives the power required for transduction from an auxiliary source, which it's not having its own source. And active transducer are those which do not require an auxiliary power source. for the production of their output. It has there its own source of power. They are also known as self-generating type, since they produce their own voltage or current output on their own and they do not require the another output signal for their operation. And some of the passive transducer, that is termed as electrical transducer, their electrical parameters, that is resistance, capacitance and some other forms and principle of operations and applications are listed here. You can see that we have discussed the classification on the basis of principle use, that is capacitive, inductive and the resistive. We have seen, we will see about the active or passive transducer and primary or secondary transducer, analog or digital transducer, transducer or inverse transducer. These all are some basic criteria on the basis of we classify the transducer. So let's discuss about the resistive transducer. Resistive transducer depends on the change in the resistance of a circuit, due to which we convert the change in resistance into some electrical form and we can calculate it and we can just sense the changes in the input signal through the output signal, that is our resistance. Here we measure the resistance in some electrical form. So on the basis of priorities, we can see the potentiometer, strain gauge, thermistor and resistance thermometer for the resistance transducer. But resistance transducer have different or many applications. Some of them are, and the classification of resistive transducer are more than the listed here. Some of them are resistance strain gauge, that is very important form where the change in the value of resistance of metal semiconductor due to the elongation or compression is known by the measurement of torque, displacement or force. We will also see about the resistance thermometer, that is widely used where the changes in the resistance of metal wire due to the change in the temperature known by the measurement of temperature. So it is basically based on the change in the temperature of input devices, where we will measure the basically temperature of input devices. We will also see the resistance hygrometer, in which the change in the resistance of conductive strip due to the change in the moisture content is known by the value of its corresponding humidity. So this will have a wide variety of application where we have to calculate the humidity of a environment. This can be used in some many applications where we have to discuss about its humidity. So basically this is used to measure the humidity in any environment. So it is having a wide applications. We can also see the resistive transducer on the basis of hot wire meter. Here the change in the resistance of a heating element due to the convection cooling of a flow of a gas is known by its corresponding gas flow or pressure. We can also see the resistive transducer on the basis of photoconductive cells. Here in the photoconductive cell, the change in the resistance of a cell due to a corresponding change in light flux is known by its corresponding light intensity. Here I have listed about the thermistor. Thermistor we are going to discuss where the change in the resistance of a semiconductor that has a negative coefficient of resistance is known by its corresponding measure of temperature. And we will see about the potentiometer type of resistive transducer. In that, the change in resistance of a potentiometer reading due to the movement of the slider of a part of an external force applied is known by its corresponding pressure or displacement. So it is basically based on some mechanical input in the terms of pressure or displacement or change in some length component, which will be measured through the resistive transducer. So these are basically the type of resistive transducer. Next is our capacitance transducer. In the capacitance transducer, we can measure the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. Here, through the measurement of capacitance, we can see the change in the input signal. How? on the basis of parallel plate capacitors, the formula for the capacitance between two parallel plate capacitors can be seen and can be used for the C or to see the change in some input signal. And capacitive transducer can be classified, or can be there are some types of capacitance. Transducer are variable capacitance, pressure gauge, capacitor microphone, dielectric gauge, and these are some capacitance transducer type. In variable plate variable capacitance pressure gauge, the principle of operations involved is the distance between the two parallel plate is varied by an externally applied force, and the applications will be the measurement of displacement pressure in terms of some deformation, or we will see the changes in the force applied to some input devices. In the capacitor microphone, the principle of operations involved is sound. Pressure varies the capacitance between a fixed plate and a movable diaphragm, and its areas of application will be the speech, music, noise will be here some areas of applications of capacitor microphone. Then in the dielectric gauge, the principle of operation involved is the variation in the capacitance by change in the dielectric. So its areas of applications involved is the liquid level and the thickness. We will calculate this with the dielectric gauge capacitance transducer. Next is our inductance transducer. So its principle of operation will be the either self-inductance or mutual inductance. So here we will see some types of inductance transducers are magnetic circuit transducers, and the principle of operation for this transducer will be the self-inductance or mutual inductance of AC excited coil is varied by the change in the magnetic circuit, and we will discuss in detail about the magnetic circuit transducers while discussing in the upcoming classes. And areas of application for this magnetic circuit transducer will be the pressure and displacement measurement. Next is our reluctance pickup. Here the principle of operation involved is the reluctance of magnetic circuit is varied by the changing position of the iron core of a coil. And the areas of application for the reluctance pickup transducers are the pressure, displacement, vibration, position. These things will be measured with the reluctance type of inductance transducer, and it has a wide areas of application in respect of others. And next we will see about the differential transformer, in which the principle of operations involved is the differential voltage of two secondary winding of a transformer is varied by positioning the magnetic core to an externally applied force. So it has the areas of application will be the pressure, force, displacement, position, and changes in the length of any input devices. And the next is on eddy current gauge, where the principle of operation involved is the inductance of a coil is varied by the proximity of an eddy current plate, and its areas of applications will be the displacement and thickness. So these are some kind of the inductance transducer which we are going. Our next classification is based on the voltage and current transducers. Here the first one is the Hall effect pickup. In that, the principle of operation will be the potential difference is generated across a semiconductor plate, which may be the, for example, germanium, when the magnetic flux interacts with an applied current. So the areas of applications will be the magnetic flux or current. Next is the ionization chamber. Its operations principle will be the electron flow inductance by ionization of a gas into radioactive radiation. Its applications will be on particle counting or radiation, or in some research applications. Next is one photo emission cell. Its principle of operation will be the electron emission due to incidence radiation on photo emission surface. and its application will be the light and radiation. And the next one is photo multiplier tube. You can see its principle of operation as the secondary electron emission due to incidence radiation in photosensitive cathode. And its application will be light and radiation photosensitive relays. So these are some voltage and current type of transducer and its principle of operation and its applications and discussed in some short here. And in detail we will discuss while discussing in upcoming classes. So these are some very voltage and current type of transducer. Next is our active transducer. They are also called a self-generating transducer because of that they do not require any external power source for their effect, and they produce an analog voltage or current when simulated by some physical form of energy. So they are self-generating type of transducers and have their own power source. So their types are listed here are first one thermocouple and thermopile. In the thermocouple and thermopile, the principle of operation will be the when a EMF is generated across the junction of the two dissimilar metals or semiconductor when that junction is heated. So its applications will be the temperature, heat flow, radiation, and these are some kind of its applications. Then next one is our moving coil generator, and in that moving coil generator the principal operation will be the base one, as the motion of a coil is magnetic field. In a magnetic field generates a voltage, means when a coil is moved in a magnetic field it generates a voltage, and its applications will be on the basis of calculation of velocity or calculation of vibrations. So it has a good quality or it has a good kind of applications. Our next type is piezoelectric pickup. In that kind and the areas of application is like that an EMF is generated when any external source or external force is applied to certain crystalline material such as quartz, sound or vibration. And its areas of application will be the calculation of acceleration and change in the pressure. So piezoelectric transducers have a wide areas of application. We can see it in the our ultrasonic transducers have a wide area of applications. Our next kind is photovoltaic cell. For that principle of operation involved is that when a voltage is generated in a semiconductor junctions device when a radiation energy simulates the cell, and its applications will be the light meter or solar cell. So here we have seen about the primary transducers, which is called as active transducers. There are some other kind of transducers are also there, such as primary transducers and secondary transducers. So LVDT transducers, which almost all know about that, linear variable differential transducers. It can be used for the primary and secondary transducer both. In that case, a photon tube acting as a primary detector senses the pressure and converts the pressure into a displacement of its free end. And the displacement of the free end moves the core of the linear variable differential transducer, which produces an output voltage. So it can be used for the primary and secondary transducer both. Another kind of transducers are analog transducers, transducers convert the input quantity into an analog output, which is a continuous function of time, and it can be used for the strain gauge, LVDT, thermocouple and thermistor. There are other kinds are digital transducers, which converts the input quantity into some electrical output, which is in the form of pulses. So these are some digital transducers. Next we are going to discuss about the factors to be considered while selecting some transducers. So here are some factors are listed, and first one is it should have high input impedance and low output impedance to avoid the loading effect, and the next one is it should have a good resolution over its entire selected range. It also must be highly sensitive to desired signal and insensitive to unwanted signal, so that we can only calculate the required input signal which can be sensed and no unwanted signal will be recorded. And it must preferably small in the size, so it can be compacted in nature and it can be used for different kind of application. It should also be able to work in a corrosive environment, and it should be able to withstand pressure, shock and vibration. So it must be rigid enough to be used in such kind of areas and applications. And it must have high degree of accuracy and repeatability, so that we can be able to calculate exact data over a number of time. So it has must good or high degree of accuracy and repeatability, so that and it must be free from such errors, so that the exact value can be calculated for over a wide range or for a number of time. The requirement of a good transducers are listed here. So we all know that requirement for a good transducers may be a general thing. Here are listed some of the things are: it must be smaller in size and weight so that we can use it for the different areas of applications with a low weight, and so that it can be used for a very tiny applications. It must be highly sensitive so that a small change in the input signal can be detected as and when a very small change is detected. It must have a high resolution and it must able to withstand environmental condition, so that we can use it for a wide areas of applications. So a good transducers can be used in some many cases, and although it must have a low cost so that can be used for different applications. In the current presentation we see about the classification of transducers, and on the basis of the different classification and different type of transducer we see their areas of applications, and we have also seen their principle of operations. And after that we have discussed about the factors for the selection of different kind of transducers for the different applications, and the classification we have discussed broadly on some category on the basis of transduction form which is used, on some primary and secondary transducers, on the basis of active and passive transducers, and the transducers and the inverse transducers. Broadly, once a generalization is concerned with energy consideration, wherein they are classified as active and passive transducer. So we have seen about the transducers, their classification and the factors for the selection of transducers. In the upcoming classes we will discuss about some specific sensors and transducers.